Today I'm going to teach you two different tutorials which went viral on my TikTok and Instagram accounts. In the first part, I will show you how to design this captivating slide in PowerPoint. You can use it for so many different ideas. For example, you can utilize it in your welcome slide. Or you have a brand, so you can introduce it with this method. In the second tutorial, I will teach you how to design these animations in PowerPoint. But before we start, let me tell you that you can download all the templates I have designed in the Patreon website. For example, let's watch this template. This template is designed with modern features and it is fully customizable to suit your brand. It has 100 unique slides and each slide has its own features. This template is designed to impress your audience. So elevate your next presentation with this mind-blowing template. The download link is in the description. Alright, let's start the tutorial. Okay, let's start by bringing the picture to the slide. From Insert tab, click on the picture and insert it from this device. Now draw a rectangle and cover the entire slide with it. Let's add a text box and type the title here. In this case, I'm going to use the Corto Heavy font style. The download link is in the description. Let's set its size to 344. Resize it, then adjust it to the center. Now align it to the middle and center. Hold the Ctrl key down, select the rectangle first, then the text box. Go to the Shape Format tab, and in the Merge Shape section, choose Combine. Let me remove the outline of this shape and fill it with a white color. Right-click on it and choose Format Shape. Add a drop shadow to the center. Set Transparency to 0 and Blur to 40. Add a blank slide. Then draw a rectangle, which covers bottom half of the slide. In this window, select Gradient Fill and remove these two spots. For this spot, set black color and choose Linear Up Direction. Choose black color for the other spot, but increase its transparency to 100%. Now remove its outline. Okay, add a text box and type your title and details. Now press Ctrl A to select all the content, then press Ctrl G to group them. In the first slide, select the picture and the shape, then copy and paste them into the next slide. We have to send the picture to the back, so click on the outside to deselect them, then right-click on it and send it back. Now you can see the order of each layer. Let's zoom out completely. You can do it from here or use the Ctrl key and a scroll wheel. Hold the Ctrl and Shift keys down and expand the shape as much as you can. Let's adjust it like this. Keep in mind, you have to expand it as much as you can see the entire slide completely. For example, this size is not acceptable. But how can I expand the size of the shape more than this? To solve this problem, select the shape, go to Shape Format tab, click on this little arrow, and then check Lock Aspect Ratio. Now I can increase the size of the shape without any problem. Since we have locked the aspect ratio, its width is changing accordingly. Let's set its height to 120. As you see, now I can fit the slide in this position. Anyway, select the picture and zoom back to the original size. Now we can add the morph transition to the second slide. Let's see it in the slideshow mode. Very good, but it is not what I want. I want to animate the title. To do that, select the group, copy and paste it into the first slide, and drag it down. But be careful, the order of all the layers in both slides should be the same. It means I have to bring this shape to the front. Let's see a preview. For the last step, I want to animate the picture as well. In the first slide, select the picture through the numbers. Then hold the Ctrl and Shift keys down and expand it. Now adjust it like this. Okay, your PowerPoint is ready.
I hope you enjoyed the first part. If you did, give it a big thumb up. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel, please consider subscribing. Alright, let's dive in and start the next part.
In this section, I'm going to teach you how to design this slide. So, without any further ado, let's get started. Let's start by drawing a rectangle. Set its height to 6 and width to 1.3. Drag it to this side, then press Ctrl D 8 times. Now drag this shape to this side, then press Ctrl A to select all the shapes. Go to the Shape Format tab and in the Align menu, choose the serviette horizontally. And then align them to the top. Draw an oval, set its height to 3.5 and width to 15. Let me increase its transparency to 50%. Align it to the center, then hold the Shift key down and put it in this position. Hold the Ctrl and Shift keys down and make another copy in this position. Select all the shapes, then go to the Shape Format tab and in the Mesh Shape section, choose Fragment. While all the shapes are selected, hold the Ctrl key down and deselect the main rectangles. Okay, let's delete the rest of them. Now bring your picture to the slide. Let's send it back. Keep in mind, your picture should be bigger than the shapes. So expand it a little bit until it covers the entire shapes. Now hold the Ctrl key down and select the picture first, then the shapes. Choose Fragment from the Mesh Shapes menu. We don't want this part, so delete it. Change the background color to black. Let's add the title to the slide. It is time to animate the pictures. First, we have to select all the pictures, but the order of selection is important. Hold the Ctrl key down and select the pictures in this order. Now go to the Animation tab and add fly-in animation to them. Let's open the Animation pane. Make sure all the animations are selected. Choose Start with Previews with 1 second duration. Let's see a preview. Very good, but if you remember, I told you the order of selection is important. Now I can easily add a delay for each picture. For example, select these two and set 0.25 seconds delay for them. For these two, 0.5 seconds. For these, 0.75. And for the last picture, set 1 second delay. Okay, let's see how it looks like. Interesting, but let's make it a little smoother. Select all the animations and open the Properties window. Drag a smooth end to the end and you are done. Your PowerPoint is ready.
It was all for today's video. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, please consider subscribing. I'll see you next video.